Hello everyone, my name is Glenn Moynihan. I'm a research software engineer at Inveni Labs. Today I'm going to talk to you about some recent challenges we faced in our machine learning models, specifically around the proliferation of glue code in our feature engineering pipelines and how we went about solving it with our new package, Feature Transforms. So there are many steps to writing an effective model. One of the most important involves deriving some meaningful features from a given dataset to train the model. In many instances, once this pipeline is written and the model is making reasonable predictions, it is rarely given a second thought or revisited. Downstream users rarely have an accurate idea of what exactly is going on in these pipelines, especially if they didn't write it. But if you pull back the curtain, you might find it's full of dragons and monsters and perhaps more than a few bugs. In the worst cases, this pipeline jungle is thousands of lines long, only a small fraction of which is actually useful, and the majority of it is glue code holding the whole thing together. If you try to remove seemingly unneeded parts, everything breaks. If you try to add some new operation, you have to change code in multiple unrelated places. Debugging is impossible, you don't even know where to look. Pipelines like this can create hidden vulnerabilities in machine learning systems and pose obstacles to future development. So how do we get here? And is there anything we can do? Let's first understand the challenges of feature engineering that lead us down this path. First, feature engineering is typically exploratory, where new components get added iteratively as insights are learned. This process might also involve several people, including future you. So new developments encourage a tactical style of programming, such as writing glue code to get new components working quickly. And as this happens, complexity grows. Increasing glue code also leads to highly coupled components, which makes pipelines very brittle and error prone, and increases the change amplification. More glue code also means fewer unit tests and over-reliance on integration tests, which makes debugging much more difficult. Finally, this environment creates a feedback loop, inviting more technical debt with no incentive to refactor until progress grinds to a halt. At this point, you end up defaulting in your debt and throwing it all out to start again. And I know that we encountered all of these problems here at Invenia, which motivated us to find a solution. These points are discussed in more detail in this paper by Scully et al., published at NeurIPS in 2015. They note that the key to avoiding the worst of pipeline jungles is to think holistically about your pipelines and wrap black box components in common APIs. So after thinking about this, we asked, what are the characteristics of an ideal pipeline? The first is that the transformations should be composable. That is, it should be easy to pipe transforms without glue code, and I should be able to insert and remove transforms without the code breaking. Secondly, transformations should be reusable. It should be easy to add a new transform, which should work in all supported types and not just one, like data frames. It should also be easy to add support for new types. I shouldn't have to use glue code to convert to a non-native type first and then back. While we're at it, let's try to make the operations efficient and time and memory costs dominated by the operation and not the container that I'm using. And finally, it would be nice to support multidimensional data beyond tables. Tables have their utility, but models that support multidimensional arrays will require additional glue code if the data is just represented across two dimensions. So now let's turn these user stories into requirements. Composability implies that a transform should be pipeable and that the output of one transform is a valid input to another, where type is preserved. Taking this idea further, you could argue that a pipeline is just a generalization of a transform on some input data. So the output of a pipeline itself should also be transformable. This takes into account the holistic approach where we might be concatenating multiple pipelines along some particular branch in our system, and the whole thing needs to be stable. To allow for reusability, we want some bottom layer API for supporting new transforms and some top layer API for supporting new types, with some interstitial methods in between to keep the whole thing together. I'll note that the feature transforms natively supports arrays and tables, including data frames, keyed arrays, access arrays, and we've also extended it for another of our packages, access sets. Finally, the underlying transforms are defined on generic arrays so that the conversion to and from special types is minimized and efficient algorithms can be used. As an illustration, this is what the bottom API looks like for defining a new transform. You just need to define the underscore apply method, as well as its cardinality. This makes use of some internal helper functions, mapping it to the top layer. How you extend the top layer API depends on your use case, But all it involves is defining the apply method with the appropriate positional and keyword arguments to select the relevant subarray or columns or components, which then get passed to the bottom layer method. For an example of how we did this for non-native type, you might like to check out access sets. Before proceeding to a demo, I thought I'd address why we didn't use or extend an existing package. There are many packages that we've used in the past for table wrangling, such as data frames meta, data knots, and query. However, these packages are more suited to performing relational operations on tables for general purpose wrangling, and they're not particularly well suited to the kinds of mathematical operations we wanted to use in our pipelines. Similarly, we also consider using MLJ, which provides a transformers mechanism that is an extension of our model's interface. But we decided against this because from the outset, we wanted something with an agnostic front end that could be a sibling package to impute.jl and have strong interoperability with our current code base. So let's take a look at the example from the README. Say we've been given some table to perform feature engineering on. Although we want to move beyond tables, I'll use it as an example here for simplicity. The first thing we want to do is check that it's supported by feature transforms, which we can do by calling isTransformable. This checks the table can be called with some apply method. Say our operations consist of a standardization scaling, a linear combination, and a one-hot encoding. There are a few ways we can operate on this table now. The first is a generic apply method, which just returns the result of the transform on the data you selected. But note that transforms are also callable, so this is equivalent to doing that. The second is to mutate the data directly, if the transform types allow. And finally, you can append the result of apply directly to the table or the array, again, if this is compatible with the types. If we wanted, we can compose these operations into a basic feature engineering pipeline by extending the transform function. A soft requirement of this method is that its output is also transformable. And since each transform returns a data frame, it makes it easier to enforce that contract. So in summary, pipeline jungles pose many challenges to machine learning and data science workflows, but some of the symptoms of complexity can be mitigated by addressing the root causes stemming from excessive use of glue code. Feature transforms provides one potential avenue to do this by focusing on composability, reusability, and performance of these transforms. In future, we hope to continue to add more transforms to the package and integrate it more closely with our other feature engineering packages, namely impute.jl and access sets, which I also encourage you to check out. Thank you for your attention.